Hi everyone, I'm Debbie Frey. Welcome to Children's Liturgy of the Word on this, the Feast of the Epiphany. This is the last Sunday that we'll spend celebrating the Christmas season. Next Sunday, it'll be back to ordinary time. But until then, we're going to start today by celebrating the Feast of the Epiphany. The word epiphany means to be revealed or to discover. And today, we're going to learn about three wise men who came from the East who had a very big epiphany when they found Jesus in the manger. We're going to begin by singing a song that I hope you know, and it's called We Three Kings. Will you sing it with me? Here we go. Boys and girls, thanks for singing along. And now we'll begin our Children's Liturgy of the Word. We have our sacred space all set up. Our Christ candle is lit because he is our light. And we'll begin, as always, by making the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And our first reading, boys and girls, once again, is from the prophet Isaiah. People of Jerusalem, arise, stand up, your light has come. The glory of God shines on you, and the rulers of nations will come to your shining light. Look all around you and see people are gathering and coming to you. They will come from far away, bringing gifts of gold and frankincense and singing the praises of God. The word of the Lord. Boys and girls, say it with me. Thanks be to God. Very good. And our responsorial psalm is, all the people on the earth rejoice to hear of the Savior's birth. Can you say that with me? All the people on the earth rejoice to hear of the Savior's birth. Proclaim salvation, God's wonders done for the earth. Say it with me. All the people on the earth rejoice to hear of the Savior's birth. Now, boys and girls, we're going to hear the gospel, so I invite you to stand up. I'm going to sing the Alleluia, and then I'm going to ask you to sing it with me the second time. Are you ready? Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Can you sing that with me? Sing it with your heart. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Good news, good news, Alleluia. The world will know of his love. Sing it with me again. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Boys and girls, the Lord be with you. And your response, say it with me. And with your spirit. A reading from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Boys and girls, your response, say it with me. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus was born in the Bethlehem of Judea, the Magi came from the east. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they asked the people, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him." When they said this, King Herod and all the people of Jerusalem became very disturbed. Herod gathered the leaders of the Jewish people and asked them where the Messiah was supposed to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea." Then Herod asked the Magi to tell him the exact time they had seen the star in the east. When they told him, Herod said, "Go to Bethlehem and find out all that you can about this child. When you have found him, come back and tell me, so that I may go too and worship him." And so they left for Bethlehem. The star which they had seen in the east went ahead of them, and it stopped over the place where Jesus was. When they went in, they found the child with Mary, his mother. They were filled with joy. They knelt down and worshiped Jesus, and they gave him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. That night, God told the Magi in a dream not to go back to Herod. So they went back to their country by another way. Gospel of the Lord. Your response, say it with me. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Very good. Take a seat for me. So a couple of weeks ago, on December 21st, about 4 days before Christmas, something happened in the sky that had not happened in over 800 years. Two planets, Jupiter and Saturn, passed each other and they overlapped. And when they did, it looked like a big bright ball in the sky. And a lot of people were calling it the Christmas star because it was happening right before Christmas. I went out and I tried to see it. And I remember that night, it was very cloudy and I was on my front porch and I couldn't see any stars or the moon because it was so cloudy. But there were a great many people around the world who did see it happen. And many of them took pictures and shared them on the internet. Do you want me to show some of them to you? So these are some pictures of what happened that night when those two planets overlapped. And I'm sure all the millions of people that saw it were amazed. And they probably took pictures and shared them on social media or texted them to their friends or family, and then they went back to whatever they were doing. But back in Jesus's time, when another bright light appeared in the sky, there were three wise men in the east known as the Magi, or the three wise men. And they didn't just look at the star and how beautiful it was. They actually followed it. They packed their bags, they climbed onto their camels, and they set out to follow wherever that star would lead. Because they believed if they could find the point where that star stopped, then they would find the Son of God. Isn't that incredible? Isn't that unbelievable? They actually set out in the night following a star. And they could only travel at night because you couldn't see the star during the day. I wonder what their friends and family thought when they said that they were going to leave and follow a star. They didn't know where it was going or where it was going to stop. And this is just another one of the incredible ways in our Christmas stories that we're learning about how God reaches out to us in beautiful and powerful ways. Remember Mother Mary when the angel Gabriel appeared and spoke to her? Remember Joseph? He was asleep. He was dreaming when God spoke to him. And now we have three wise men, and they see a magnificent light coming from the sky, And they have to follow it. They have to leave everything and find out where it stops. And all of them had their own epiphany. All of them had it revealed to them that Jesus is here and he's real. So boys and girls, I've created an epiphany craft this Sunday. This is my epiphany star. And it was shared with me by our friends at Illustrated Ministry. And I'm going to put a link to it. And I hope that you'll also make one of these epiphany stars this weekend. And I hope you'll enjoy it. But while you're making it, here's what I want you to think about. I want you to think about God and all the ways that he is leading us to his Son. When we're awake, when we're asleep, when we're looking up at the sky, he's always pointing us to his Son and saying, look, here he is. He is my gift to you. And let's pray that we'll always be like the wise men and willing to go wherever we have to go and do whatever we have to do to find him. Now, boys and girls, I'm going to lead you in the prayers of the faithful. Remember, the prayers of the faithful are the prayers that we all pray together at the same time, and we're all asking God for the same thing at once. They're so very powerful. So will you join me now? And your response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the doctors, nurses, scientists, and all the people who are working hard to keep us safe during COVID-19. We pray to the Lord. Boys and girls, say it with me. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all of the teachers and educators who are going to begin teaching us again, even though we're in lockdown, may we always do our best work. And may God bless them for how they are helping us. We pray to the Lord. Boys and girls, say it with me. Lord, hear our prayer. And lastly, for the new year of 2021, may it be filled with blessings and hope and peace in the most perfect gift we ever received, the gift of Jesus. We pray to the Lord. Boys and girls, say it with me. Lord, hear our prayer. Well, that's all for today for Children's Liturgy. I'll be back next Sunday, but until then, be safe, be well, and keep following the Lord wherever he leads. You'll never be sorry. Bye for now.